All right, let's talk about right-sizing, the bureaucracy. We have with us Marikina Representative Stella Quimbo. Good morning to you, Congresswoman Quimbo.
Good morning, Karen, and to all your viewers.
All right, it's estimated that more than 2 million members of the government will be affected with what the Department of Budget and Management calls right-sizing. First of all, do you agree in general with the concept of streamlining the bureaucracy?
Well, as an economist, Karen, I completely believe in the idea of having an optimal size of a government. So right now we're talking about right-sizing. We're not talking about downsizing. So we're not necessarily only going to talk about downsizing, because there could be situations, Karen, like in some government agencies, nakulang naman ang plantilla positions. Mm-mm. So remember, ultimately, although ang na-emphasize talaga dito is really the savings that can be had from reducing the number of positions. But for me, really, the bigger benefit is really the efficient delivery of services. Karen, as a taxpayer, may mga situations na pupunta tayo sa isang government agency, nagtataka tayo, teka muna, bakit ang dami-daming nag-aasikaso? Or at the same time, in situations naman na it's the complete opposite, nakulang-nakulang ang nag-aasikaso sa'yo. So, it's about time na pag-aralan na talaga kung saan kulang or kung saan sobra naman. Mm-hmm. And so yun, for me, that's the idea of right-sizing. It's really the optimal size of government.
Okay. Now, while of course this is commendable, it does affect economic recovery also with the personal lives of those in government. We're talking about pandemic recovery for their families as well. How do you balance that?
Well, absolutely. That's a very, very important concern. So obviously, economic recovery, the main focus is job creation. So wag tayo dito sa job destruction. So, well, first of all, this won't happen overnight. Kailangan pag-aralan na mabuti. And number two, we have to keep in mind that as we abolish, if we need to abolish, we need to minimize displacement among workers. And how to do that? I mean, there are tools, for example, like early retirement. Okay. So in other words, for positions that are outdated, chances are, Karen, mga senior na siguro mga nakaupo dyan, the fact na nag-obsolete na siya, outdated, malamang medyo may katandaan ng nakaupo dyan. So pwede naman natin either hintayan ng retirement or alokin ng early retirement. Mm-hmm. Or in a situation where medyo mabata pa yung nakaupo sa isang obsolete na position na tatanggalin, pwede natin alokin ng retooling programs. So that's the reason for why hindi tayo pwedeng padalos-dalos. Right-sizing would require also putting in the necessary safety nets so that we don't displace workers, especially today, that we really need to create jobs.
Okay. And Congresswoman, what about contractuals in government? Do you have an estimate of just how many do you believe will be affected?
Well, okay. First of all, again, the reason for why we have a lot of job orders or contractuals in government is because we have not really sat down and thought about the correct number of staff positions in government. So ang dahilan kung bakit we end up hiring consultants is because hindi available yung plantilla position or napakahirap humingi ng plantilla position sa DBM. Mm-hmm. So yun eh, parang chicken and an egg thing eh. So tingin ko, if we do right-sizing and then we make a determination, agency X needs X plantilla positions at ito ang skill set na kailangan, ito yung specific staff position, full-time, part-time, etc., hindi na, mami-minimize din natin ang need for consultants. But as of now, so meron tayong close to 2 million na plantilla positions, pero tama ka, Karen, marami pang consultants kasi yon naman ay naka-charge under MOOE. Unfortunately, I don't have the exact number, pero tingin ko if 28% ang share ng personnel services sa total budget, tingin ko if you put in the mga consultants and JO, baka umabot pa sa 40% ang share ng total salaries for manpower.
Mm-mm. The term right-sizing, it's sending mixed signals to different parts of government. And I'll tell you one. The DOLE Secretary, Labor Secretary Bienvenido Laguesma, already announced that in plans to right-size the government, there will be no retrenchment it does not automatically mean retrenchment. But if you right size, it would mean some would have to be removed. So would not that be equal to retrenchment?
I guess if our workers opt for early retirement or mandatory retirement, that's not technically retrenchment. So I think papunta doon, palagay ko. I mean, that's the way to reconcile both statements.
And the announcement is roughly 5%. The aim is actually to remove just 5% of redundant government positions. Would you consider this number accurate, Congresswoman, considering you said earlier we haven't even determined just which positions we need?
To be honest, Karen, I think it's a little bit premature to say it's 5%, 6%. First step talaga, what's the baseline situation? We have not done an inventory of staff position. And hindi lang ito pagbibilang, ito yung dami ng staff position. Hindi eh, kailangan ka mag-time and motion studies eh. Kung ito ang mandato ng isang ahensya, these are the number of approvals that need to be done in X number of months, et cetera, et cetera. Then you make a determination, ilang tao ang kailangan ko. Saka ka babalik at sasabihin, ay tingnan muna, sobra pala ako ng tao. Or kulang ako ng tao for that matter. So, hindi natin alam eh. So, may mga ahensya na malamang, baka nga mag-increase pa ang staff position. So, halimbawa, remember, very important na mag-digital pivot ang ating gobyerno. And at this point in time, malamang kulang ang staff positions na merong ganong klaseng skill set. So, malamang magdadagdag tayo ng ganong klaseng staff position. But what's the net effect? Karen, it's very hard to say at this point in time. So ang tingin ko, wag natin i-preempt. Ang importante is, nandyan ang political will to do this. Bata pa lang ako na teacher, Karen, sa UP, lahat na ng mga policy researchers, ito na talaga ang panukala that we really need to right-size the bureaucracy. It can be bloated. So it's a very good opportunity. Nandyan ang political will, nandyan ang political capital ng ating Pangulo. So sana gamitin ng mabuti para finally magawa na itong very important reform.
Okay, so the savings of 14.8 billion that they've announced so far, let's be honest, we're not seeing that in the next year or even in the next 2 years?
I doubt that, Karen, kasi tandaan natin, no, meron tayong GOCC Act na pinasa noong 2011. And one of the mandates of the GCG is precisely to right-size the GOCCs. Eh, fast forward to today, 11 years after, out of 180 GOCCs, apat pa lang nare-right-size.
Oh, wow.
So, may
kabagalan. That's really...
Yeah. So, but it's a different situation today, Karen. Pag nandiyan ang political will, babalangkasan ng Pangulo na importante ito, lalagyan ng pondo, kasi very important yung budget. Diba? Saan ka kukuha ng pera para maggawa ng early retirement program? Kailangan mong pondohan yan. So kung nandun ang necessary ingredients, palagay ko naman mas mabilis tayo sa GCG sa pag-right size.
Okay, so that's one. Political will is a big issue. The track record so far with GOCCs has been very slow and very poor in terms of the speed of actually right-sizing. What about certain agencies that have been quite controversial in the past few years in the 18th Congress that even some senators and congresswomen like yourself have said to remove this? Let's talk about certain attached agencies. For example, how many are you seeing that should be considered to be removed immediately?
Again, Karen, it's very difficult to make that to make any assessments. Pero ako, I've said, for example, I've said this many times in public and I've been very vocal about it. Like PhilHealth, which is an attached agency to DOH, talagang alam natin very inefficient ang pag-deliver ng services nila. And I had over and over again recommended that we can outsource from the private sector certain functions, no? So the question there is, anong ibig sabihin nun? Kukunti ba ang empleyado sa PhilHealth? Well, not necessarily, again, kasi pag tinanong mo ang PhilHealth, ilan bang abogado mo? Kasi para tugisin lahat ng mga unscrupulous ng mga partners, ang kaunti, di ba? So baka naman, you know, on one hand, pwede mong bawasan in certain operating segments na pwede mong outsource sa private sector. On the other hand, dadamihan mo naman doon sa segments na kulang na kulang ang tao mo. Mm-mm. So again, very difficult to talk about the net effect at this point in time.
Oo. But then for example, that's one. And then offices like, for example, PITC, PSDBM. I mean, I'm unsure just how many personnel there would be in those specific offices. Do you believe that would help? That should be much faster?
I guess the question kasi is, do we appreciate the mandate of certain agencies?
Yeah.
So obviously, PSDBM naging controversial. But if you ask me, ha, maganda naman yung idea eh. Maganda yung idea na tutulungan ng PSDBM ang mga ahensya to procure. Kaya nagtrabaho ako sa gobyerno buong buhay ko. Talagang laking ahensya ako. Napakahirap talaga mag-procure under very archaic procurement laws. So maganda sana yung, ang mandato ng PSDBM. So ang tingin ko, ang question doon is...
Kaso naabuso.
Naabuso. So baka ang tingin ko, ang sagot doon is transparency. Kapag transparent talaga ang methods, na baka live stream siya, nanonood ang publiko, nanonood ang media, may CCTV, eh palagay ko talagang mababawasan dyan ang if ever, no, hindi magandang gawain. Mm-hmm. So having said that, huwag natin i-preempt yung question on how many people will be removed from those agencies. Oo. And tingin ko, balikan ang mandato, paano gagawin ang mandato sa isang mabuting paraan, magandang paraan, mabilis na paraan. And next question, ilang tao ang kailangan mo?
And ang controversial dito niyan, Congresswoman, is who determines which positions are not needed, which agencies can be let go of. Who determines that? Is it just the secretary? Should it be like a specific body? Sino po yun?
I think it has to be in different levels. Pagdating sa dami ng plantilla positions within an agency, kasi galing nga ako sa ahensya, kaya yun ng head eh. And iniisip ng mga tao, hindi, matagal yan. Alam mo, hindi. Doon sa karanasan namin sa Philippine Competition Commission. It was a new commission. I was one of the founding commissioners. And ang nangyari doon, when we started, binigay na sa amin yung dami ng plantilla positions. So it was already a fixed number of plantilla positions, even when at that point in time, we did not have yet a clear understanding of how to execute our function because we needed to build our capacity, etc. And then maybe 1 year later, we realized that we needed a certain number, a correct number of plantilla positions. But at that point in time, it was too late. It was very difficult to get plantilla positions from DBM. So tingin ko yun ang nangyayari. Pag nakikreate ang isang ahensya, nagkakaroon ng parang assumed number of positions, as meaning assumed that that will support the mandate. But... hindi naman yun pala yung kailangan. So, yun ang nangyayari over time. Kaya hindi, malamang sa malamang, hindi correct ang number ng plantilla position sa bawat ahensya.
Oo. Now, would privatization help? One example I've heard in the last few days is the question of why not privatize PAGCOR, for example? Other than, of course, it might be more profitable. Would that actually be a factor in streamlining government?
Well, they have to be... So the use of technology and right-sizing of the bureaucracy, they really have to come hand in hand. Mm-hmm. So nandyan ang digital pivoting. Like, for example, if you remember, Karen, in our distribution of ayuda, we had great difficulty distributing ayuda because that was done manually. Uh-oh. So at this point in time, kailangan na siguro tayo mag-pivot to digital, right? Mm-hmm. So the question there is, paano yun? Paano yung mga tao na hired for that purpose? Well, yun na nga. Kailangan pag-aralan. So saan yung better use of that manpower? Or kung medyo bata-bata sila, baka pwedeng ma-retool so that they can occupy other positions.
Okay. Let's talk about now the 2023 national budget. Incoming, I'd like to say incoming, but let's put it to the most likely. The Speaker of the House in the 19th Congress, Congressman Romualdez, says that he is eyeing that the 2023 national budget is actually approved by the end of the year. Are you seeing this as a possibility, ma'am?
Absolutely. That can be done. Depende lang talaga sa leadership and if that these are the pronouncements of incoming speaker, naniniwala ako. And kung naalala ninyo sa canvassing, halos hindi tumayo si Kong Martin sa kanyang upuan because he really wanted to work within a certain timeline. So nakikita ko na the same effort and energy level ay talagang exert niya para patuparin yan. Mm-mm.